experimenting on humans. Never would have gotten away with it if the Conclave were still in charge.
Ooh, a nice crossbow. Enhanced Dragon's Dream. The Mage Alexander's Log, Part 2. Day 346. I never did like rats, not because of their obscene tails, but rather on account of their lively, disturbing intelligence. They are always listening when a man believes he is talking only to himself, and what's worse, they seem to understand. A few days ago, I caught myself talking to one of them, to a particularly large black male with a torn-off ear. At first, I was overcome by panic. Was this a first manifestation of the illness? Of course, that was impossible, for I had fortified my immunity with powerful spells. Upon further consideration, I concluded it was an altogether natural reflex, one even the most learned among us find hard to restrain. We mages like to be listened to. I placed the black rat in a separate cage. The time will come for it to play a part in the tests. Meanwhile, it can keep me company, and observe. I've noticed it looks with great concentration at the cages of its infected brethren, particularly those in the last stages of illness. Fascinating. Speaking of company, I have none besides the black rat, and cannot hope for better. Viserid avoids the laboratory, and has expressed his desire for his daughter to steer clear of me as well. At first I thought he feared a moral scandal, which would be risible in the extreme, but he explained the true reason in due course. It seems Annabelle has always possessed a fragile psychic constitution. Observing the ill might throw her into foul humors. The peasants taking part in the study have stopped speaking to me. I don't know what they believe this little act of defiance will serve. It does me no harm. They made for lousy conversation partners. There remains, of course, the woman, but as for her, I try to limit my contact. Day 362. My black rat has died. Today I found him curled up in his cage. I suspected he had become infected on accident, but during the autopsy I did not uncover any signs of illness. He was also perfectly well fed. Strange. From a medical point of view, his death remains unexplained, something which I must admit irritates the scholar in me, but as mentioned previously, I'm not particularly fond of rats. Huh. The Mage Alexander's Log, Part 1. So this is a letter to Alexander that I found in Kira's hut. Keira apparently was in contact with him. And probably knew a little bit about what he was doing. Day 237. So this is the first part of his log, so this is earlier than the others. My experiments continue to return results I must consider unreliable. Methodological errors are not at fault. The problem lies in the shoddy, infallible research material I am forced to work with. Despite his prior assurance, Viserid is unable to provide me with enough moderately healthy specimens for my tests. Most of the material is starved and terrified, having been dragged here straight from the dungeon. I waste a great deal of time daily washing and delousing them before I will so much as let them step foot into my laboratory. Sterility first. As Marty Sodergren managed to prove in her little-known work, the attitude of a patient undergoing treatment can have a significant impact on the battle against the disease. Unfortunately, the volunteers with which I am supplied do not show sufficient comprehension, let alone enthusiasm, for the noble work in which they are taking part. In fact, it seems they consider the research part of their punishment. I have tried a few times, though I am but a poor speaker, to convince them that they are contributing to the eradication of one of the greatest plagues tormenting mankind. I had the distinct impression they understood little, but perhaps their stupor was merely the result of the early stages of the illness. Of course, it is impossible to achieve success without significant sacrifices. The overwhelming majority of them will have to lay down their trifling lives on the altar of learning. But that is a sacrifice I am willing to make. Well, I'm glad he was willing to sacrifice those lives for it. I'm glad he was. Ah, boy. So that's interesting. Oops, not what I wanted to do. Nope. Okay. Well, I think I'm done here. For the moment, at least. So locked. All right, well. Take Annabelle to Graham. Where is this Graham fellow? Okay, so I'm gonna go back to Oriton. We'll talk to Graham and see what he has to say.
Wild hunt, take them all.
The witch? She told me I were to educate yous. Which I now strive to do. To keep the parks off yous, you're to see to your own, what is it, hygiene, and don't drink straight from your wells. Huh? Just wash your arse once a week and boil your water over a fire.
The Blackens be evil and all, but when they rode by, one of them tossed me little Voity a chunk of bread.
Watch you don't break out with a fever.
What are you on about?
They handed out fatback in one village. Now, why, it's not but a graveyard.
Voity! Come here!
Well, let's find this Graham.
Graham, let me in! Told you, I don't want to see no one.
You've got to!
Just leave me be!
What's going on here?
I want to talk.
You deaf, damn it! I told you! Who are you?
I've been to the island. I know what happened there.
What do you want of me?
Want to talk to you about Annabelle.
Annabelle? What can you know about her?
I met her. Talked to her.
Annabelle's dead. Drank poison. And I couldn't save her.
Did you love her?
Oi. Something mad. Loved her so deep, I believed we'd come through, believed we'd be together. Of course, it was not to her father's liking. His daughter and a plain lout.
You know what happened?
What happened on Fyke Isle? You gotta tell me.
T'were Millie, Finch, and Faulkner. They rallied the men, all roughs, to go to the Isle, take back what was ours from the noble. They knew I was known at the tower, that the Lord's servants would open the gate for me since I sold them fish.
They forced you to go with them?
No, I saw my chance in it, for Annabelle and me to flee. But it all spun in a chaos. Our boys from the village, they started killing everyone. Annabelle, they wanted to rape! First, then she drank the poison. Mage must have gave it her. I ran out the tower, hollering that I wanted to die, cursing them all to hell. Don't force me to speak of it. No more, please.
What did you say exactly?
Said you were hollering as you fled the tower, the island. What exactly did you say?
I don't remember. I wanted them to pay for what they'd done to her.
Might have cursed them. There's a powerful magic aura on Fyke Isle. Passions, evil intent, strong emotions of any kind can activate it. Your words could be the curse's source.
She took the poison because of them.
Well, it wasn't actually poison.
It wasn't poison. Annabelle drank a strong sleeping potion. Mage wanted to protect her, make it look like she was dead. Convinced everyone.
That means... is she... you said you spoke to her?
Spoke to her ghost. By the time she awoke, tower was full of cold corpses. And rats. She was warm meat. Rats ate her alive.
You mean... she was alive the whole time? But... can't be. She was cold all through like a corpse. I shook her, begged her, open your eyes. I never thought...
It wasn't your fault, buddy.
It's not your fault. No guilt in not knowing, and you couldn't know it wasn't poison she drank.
Gods, what have I done? If I had stayed behind to bury her, I didn't notice she was alive. It might have ended different, ended well.
If you'd stayed on the island, I doubt you'd have survived.
I'd take death over leaving her to the rats like that. But there's naught I can do about it now.
Wrong on that count.
You can help her still.
Annabelle needs you. Her soul will only find peace if you help her.
But... what can I do? It's too late.
Bury her bones. Annabelle should be laid to rest by one who loved her. It's the only way to lift the curse that holds Fyke Isle.
Those are... her bones?
Yes.
Give them here. And leave me be.
Okay, well, I think I've done it. Uh-oh.
Dead. Annabelle was no ordinary ghost. She's a pesta. And now she's free.
Oops.
Shrine.
So, am I gonna have to kill this pesta?
Troll God demanded 6 sucklings.
Whoa there, Roach.
No wonder he cursed us. I were doomed.
Something here. Where's that artifact Keira gave me?
It's your fault as much as mine.
What are you doing here?
What? The sun flying from the moon? We're making offerings to the All God, clearly.
You too can seek his aid. That's if you've got fitting offerings. He scorned ours, then cursed the old village.
Really? Your All God, tell me more.
The All God, you call him. First I've heard. Is some new deity?
Nay, 'tis ancient, revered by our forefathers. They say it were like this. Roslav of Oriton came here to gather brushwood. And suddenly, for no reason, a bush burst into flame. Then, Roslav heard a voice from the ground, demanding offerings and obedience.
We've been coming here since then, bearing gifts, in exchange for which the All God watches over us, keeps us from evil.
Mm-hmm. Plain to see that.
So, what was wrong with your offerings?
So, what's wrong with your offerings?
You needn't mock us. You can see right well we brought scraps. Before the war, I wouldn't give this such to me hounds. But what can we do? Such are the times.
And they're like to get worse. All God said if he don't get a rafter of bacon and a barrel of beer at least, the rivers will fill up with frogs and locusts or some such will devour the harvest.
A rafter of bacon and a barrel of beer? Something tells me this is not actually a deity. Let me talk to him.
I could intercede on your behalf with this All God of yours. Got a feeling we'd come to an understanding.
Well, I suppose it can't hurt to try. To speak with him, you have to stand before the altar and cry out, All God, help a poor wretch in need. Who knows, he might just listen to a foreigner.
Oh, All God, help a poor wretch in need. Pretty please.
How dare you disturb my divine rest, mortal?
I dare disturb it because I want your divine self to lift the, curse you cast. Those peasants really don't have.
They must bring worthy offerings or they shall face drought, driving hail, earthquakes, avalanches. I have spoken.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Avalanches? Here? How would that work? No answer from the All God. Fine. We can finish our conversation when I find him. Voice came from underground. Wine. More like vinegar. Someone drank it anyway. Could follow the scent. Nahalini's eye. Ought to use it.
Where, though? Oh, here we go. Whoop. Look at that. Well, well, well.
What? Who dares disturb my divine being?
Geralt of Rivia. Pleasure. Expected the All God to be corporeal in form, but never thought he'd be corpulent. Fattened up nicely at those peasants' expense.
Expense? Expense? Not a word about the help I give in return. Blessings, absolutions, enlightened advice. Believe me, these folks need all of it. I'd watch over them still if they fulfilled their end. But lately, they offer these pathetic scraps.
That they steal from the mouths of their children, and to make matters worse, you cast a curse on them.
And I'll not lift it till they bring me worthy offerings. want to settle for curves and whey? Not a chance. And you can tell them that.
How long have you been here?
Been in this hole long?
For a century or so. One winter, I found shelter here. Built a fire so large, the flames leapt through the crack, lit the bushes above. I coughed from the smoke, and suddenly heard a peasant. A voice out of nowhere, he called. A miracle. Thus, I became a god.
Parasite, more like.
Maybe so. But what of Freya and Melitele then, hmm? Demanding prayers and offerings, given naught in return. I talk at least.
Well, maybe I should just kill him outright, because you know what? I mean, like, he's stealing food from these peasants, and has been for over 100 years. That's not very nice. They can stop giving their food away to this guy. Like, he's not actually doing anything for the peasants, so I'm just gonna kill him.
Got an idea how to resolve this. I'll just kill you.
You think this is unjust, mortal? Whosoever looks upon my godliness must die!
Damn it.
Here we go. What else have we got here? There's gotta be some more loots around here. Like, you know, he's been stealing from these peasants. That's not cool. You don't just steal from people. He's a con artist, so. Let's just talk to these fellas.
Anything new?
Yeah, your all god's dead.
Got good news. Your god's dead. It was actually a run-of-the-mill monster. Sentient, but mean. Took advantage of you. You went hungry, while it grew new chins.
What have you done? The All God warned us? Said if he ever departed, death would await us all? Come on, Tribor. We must tell the others. Only group prayer can save us now.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Really? Well, okay, guys. Sure. Whatever. Whatever. Alright, well, I'm gonna go back to, Kira's place. And, let's go back to Kira's place. The curse is gone. That's the important thing, right? Right. So, hey, Keira.
Geralt, just when I was starting to miss you.
So, tell me about this mage from the Isle.
Tell me more about this mage from the Isle. Were you two close?
Never expected you'd take such an interest in my private life.
More interested to know if you bonded, as fellow magic practitioners.
Well, we had little in common in that arena. Oh, Alexander was one of those anxious experimenters, forever short on sleep. The kind that thinks perfect happiness is an isolated tower and a full set of vials and alembics.
Right, well, I managed to remove the curse.
Fyke Isle's free of its curse.
And you withheld this news until now? Why? I gave you a Xenovox. But the curse, what was its source?
The dark spell clung to the spirit of Annabelle, the Lord's daughter. To free her and the Isle, Graham, her beloved, had to help me.
So it ended well.
I lifted the curse, so the island's clear. Annabelle's soul is free. Thing is, turned out she's a pesta. Graham's dead.
And you fail to notice? You're losing your touch. Be that as it may, Fyke Isle is free of its curse. That's important. I'm almost inclined to say good work.
Alexander was doing some strange research.
One thing's bothering me.
What?
Annabelle said Alexander was studying diseases. She mentioned Catriona. You knew this?
All the mages knew about it. Alexander was a highly regarded epidemiologist. I would have given anything for an opportunity to study his notes, but he guarded them jealously.
The lamp. What do you want to do with it?
As I said, you may keep it. I don't believe I shall need it anymore, given the Isle's been cleansed. I actually regret not going there with you. Perhaps we can make up for that lost time now.
All right. Time I was on my way.
Perhaps you'd stay just a bit longer? There's one small favor you might yet do for me.
Really?
What is it?
I put in an order for a few substances from Novigrad. The trader was due to be here yesterday, but has yet to arrive. Could you see what happened? The package is rather important to me.
Fine.
Why not? If he was coming here from Novigrad, he must have passed through Blackbow. I'll check the area.
Thank you. I shall be ever so grateful.
So I need to go north. Just gonna do a bunch of favors for Keira, I guess. I'm starting to feel like she's stringing me along here. That's okay though. I like helping people. Helping people is what I do. Hey, there's a bandit. There we go.
Thank you.
we go. This is really awkward, man. I gotta say. There we go. Just like dismembering these guys run on their horses. Come on. Come on. A low-speed horse chase. Oh, come on. Really? Ugh, it's really hard to aim these things when you're on a horse. Like, what the heck? Oh, for crying out loud. Need really way better mounted combat mechanics. It is really hard to manage. Like, what in the heck? I just keep swinging and missing. Like, I think I'm gonna hit the guy and then I don't. Ugh, for crying out loud. Come on. Stand still. To, like, come up on his left.
You'll never learn.
Jesus.
Giddy up.
Anyway.
Go, go. Take it easy.
Drowners and a water hag, my favorite.
There we go. Okay, well, let's see here. What do we got?
Wide, heavy wheels. A merchant's wagon.
Okay. Here we go.
merchant traveling across Velen alone. No way that was gonna end well.
Right?
Leftovers, cuts of meat, cataplepis. Wonder what spell requires that. Package still intact. Don't sense anything magic, though. Wonder how Kirill'll explain this one. Human, from an artery. Can't be far. Wouldn't have made it. Hid and waited for help. It never came. That's Velen for you.
Right? Missing merchant's letter. Volker. We've hit gold, old friend. Not only have we sold all of our stock, we have sold it for 3 times its cost. Our customer wants it all. Wine from Beauclair, everything from Beaujolais Nouveau to the oldest vintages, white, red, rosé, you name it, cataplepis meat, pickled beef, pepper, cinnamon, cloves, I'm telling you, the old friend, everything. There's one catch, however. We must deliver the goods to Velen, to a village called Midcops. I know, dangerous, what with the war and all, but think of the coin. I've managed to secure a pass that will get you across the Pontar. Then it's just a hop, skip, and a jump, and you're there. You'll be fine. Klaus, we'll split the proceeds 50-50. So, she wasn't looking for magical items, she just wanted, like, food and stuff.
Let's go! Go.
Now let's see how Keira explains this one. I don't know, I'm enjoying all these little errands she keeps sending me on.
Take it easy.
Like, I just think it's hilarious. Like, what does Geralt think he's gonna get out of this? I don't know. He's a sucker for a pretty face, though, let me tell ya.